Dear students, welcome back to a new mathematics session. In today's session, we shall discuss a new concept named functions from the chapter Relations and Functions. Let's move on to the topic. Let's discuss more about functions. A relation f from set A to set B is said to be a function if every element of set A has one and only one image in set B. A relation f from set A to set B, relation is from set A to set B, is a function if every element of set A is our first set, has one and only one image. If you take one particular element from set A, that element must be related to only one element in set B. So then we can say that it is a function. So let's discuss about functions through an example. Let A is equal to set of A, B, C, D. There are four elements in set A, B, C and D. And B is Aman, Ankit, Baljinder, Chandu, Egalavya. There are some names. Then A, just we are representing an oval shape, and B another oval shape we have taken. Arrow diagram, through arrow diagram we are just depicting a relation. So here ABCD is mentioned in set A, and the names we have mentioned in set B, and A is related to Aman, the same A is related to Angita as well, B is related to Baljinder, C is related to Chandu. Then for a function, as per our definition, every element of set A will have an image. You can see here every element in set A, no, D is not having an image. So in set A, D is not having an image. So the first condition for a function itself is not satisfying. You can see here, D is not having an image. Then every element of set A will only one image in set B. Image means, suppose if B is related to Baljinder, Baljinder is the image of P. These elements are called the images. B is related to Baljinder, so Baljinder is the image of B. That's what we used to say. So every element of set A will only one image in set B. But you can see here, A is having two images. With Aman also it is related, with Ankit also it is related. So these two main conditions of functions, it is not satisfied here. First condition is every element of set A will have an image. So all the elements of set A should have an image, but here B is not having any relation with the set B. And every element of set A will only one image in set B. But here when you check, A is having two images, A is having with Aman, A is having relation with Angita as well. So since D doesn't have an image here, it's not a function. This all we have discussed. So the two conditions itself, it is not satisfying, because of that it is not a function. Then let's check how it will be a function. So here A, we are taking the first set, and B, the second set we have taken. A is related to Aman, B is related to Baljinder, C is related to Chandu, D is related to Egalavya. You can see here, every element has an image, A, B, C, D. First set, all the elements, four elements also having relation in set B. And every element has only one image. You can see A is related to only one person, B is related to second person, sorry, only one person here, C is related to Chandu, and D is related to Egalavya. Not like this, A is having two relations, but here A is having only one relation. So all these two conditions are satisfied, hence it is a function. Then as before, if the function we have to mention, how we just write the relation like that, function also we can write here A Aman, then B Baljinder, C Chandu, and D comma Egalavya. This is our function, and its domain is A B C D, set of all the first set A B C D here, first set elements. And range means which are the persons which is having relation with set A, that is Aman, Baljinder, Chandu, and Egalavya. You can see here, Aman is having relation, Baljinder is having relation, Chandu is having relation, Egalavya is having relation. Only those persons. Then next is codomain. Codomain means all the elements in set B is in codomain. Aman, Ankit, Baljinder, Chandu, and Egalavya. Then Not in a function, domain will always be equal to first set. You can see here, domain, you can see here, A, B, C, D. Domain will be always equal to the first set, because if it is a function means all the elements of set A will have an image. So domain means it is equal to the first set. Now let's discuss an example for domain, codomain and range. Here a function from A to B is defined, x to 2x plus 1. And here these 1, 2, 3, 4, these are called our domain, because these elements are having a relation, having an image in the B set. So 1 is related to 3, 2 is related to 5, 3 is related to 7, and 4 is related to 9. Means when we give 1 with to this 2x plus 1, we will get 2 into 1 plus 1, that is 3. When we give 2 to this equation, we will be getting 2 into 2, 4 plus 1, 5. Like that, 3 when we give, we will get 7. And 4 when we give, we will get 9. And these are called the input values. These 1, 2, 3, 4 are called the input values. And this 3, 5, 7, 9 are called the output values. And here, if you are asked to write the domain, domain means set of all first elements. First elements means 1, 2, 3, 4. So domain will be set of 1, 2, 3, 4. Then if you are asked to write the codomain, codomain is the second set completely we will be taking. Whether it is having a pre-image in A or not, whatever it is, we will be taking the full set. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, full set. But in case of range, we will be taking only the elements which are having a relation or which are having a pre-image in A. This is called image and this is called the pre-image. One's image is 3 and 3's pre-image is 1. That is the way we used to tell in case of functions. So here 3 is having a pre-image, 5 is having a pre-image here, 7 is having a pre-image and 9 is also having a pre-image. So only these elements will be included in range. So this is what about domain, codomain and range. Next, we shall discuss about some functions and their graphs. Here, some functions names and their graphs also we have to learn. And this is a very important concept, and make sure that the concept is very clear to you, or else it will be difficult for you to recall when it is necessary. Here, first one is an identity function. Identity function, f from R to R be a function. F from R to R, R means real numbers, R to R be a function. Then f of x is equal to x for each x element of R. This is identity function. F of x is equal to x for each x element of R. F of x we can write as y. That means y is equal to x for each x element of R. X element of R means our input values, x values from the real number system. So y is equal to x for each x element of R. That is called the identity function. If identity function is asked, you have to write f of x is equal to x or y is equal to x. Then next we have to discuss about its graph. For that, just let's draw it and then learn. Then it will be easy for you to recall. So for drawing the graph, we need a set of values for x and y. Here y is equal to x means whatever value you assign for x, the same value will be coming for y. So x, if I take 0, y also will be 0. If I take x 1, y also will be 1. If I take x is minus 2, y also will be minus 2. So this is the way we have to assign the numbers for x and y. Then let's plot it in a graph sheet. As you know that x-axis, y-axis and plotting points, that is the basic needs that we have completed. Next is plotting these points, that is 0, 0, that is the first point we have marked. Next is 1, 1, x value is 1, y value is 1, that we have marked. Next is minus 2, minus 2, x is minus 2, y is minus 2, that we have marked. Then by joining these three points, we have to draw the line. So this is the graph of identity function, means f of x is equal to x or y is equal to x. So from here we have to write down the domain and range. That is also very important. For an identity function, we have to write the domain and range. Domain means all the input values. So as we know, the input values means x element of R, whatever values we are taking, it is from the real number system. Means domain is equal to all values of x, that is equal to R, real numbers. Then output value, that is called the range, means the y value is the range, means whatever x value you are taking, the same x will be coming for y as well, because x is equal to y is our function. So range is also all values of y. All values of y means all values of x, because x and y are equal. That means our range also belongs to real number system, means range R, domain also R. So here you need to keep it in mind that identity function, if it is asked, you have to write f from R to R, f of x is equal to x is the identity function, and the graph looks like this, and its domain is R and range also R. These are the three key points which you have to note from these functions and their graphs. The next function what we are going to learn is a constant function. As before, f from R to R, a function from R to R is defined, and f of x is equal to c for each x element of R. This is the constant function. F of x is equal to c. C stands for a constant, means 1, 2, 3, minus 1. These are constants. So f of x is equal to c for each x element of R, means our input value is from the real number system. So y is equal to c for each x element of R. F of x can be replaced with y. So y is equal to c for each x element of R. That is called the constant function. Let's discuss about the graph. So whatever y value you take, whatever x value you take, y will be a constant. Here x values, you can take any value from the real numbers. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, whatever you take, your y will be a constant. Means here if you take x 0, I'm taking y a constant value, that is 4. Even if you take x as 1, you will be getting 4. Even if you take x as minus 2, you will be taking 4. So x values will be changing, our input values will be changing, but our output values, the images, will be a constant number. So y is equal to c because of that. So this one we are going to represent it through a graph. So all the basic needs or requirements we have drawn, x-axis, y-axis, we have plotted the axis values and all. Then y value is 4, means x0, if you put x0, means you will be getting y4. Even if you take x is equal to 1, you will be getting 1, 4, means the point will be here. So we have marked. Then if you take x is equal to minus 2, means from here if you go, that also will be getting 4. So the three values we have plotted, and by connecting these three points, we have to draw a line. So this is a graph of y is equal to 4. Here our constant is 4, so y is equal to 4. This is the graph of y is equal to 4, means a constant function graph, if you draw, it will be always parallel to the x-axis, means y is equal to a particular constant will be coming. Maybe next time if you take the constant, maybe 1. So you have to draw a line which is parallel to y-axis 1, sorry, which is parallel to x-axis and passing through x-axis 1. A line which is parallel to x-axis and passing through this point, means y-axis 1. If you get it, or if you take your constant as a minus 3, that means y-axis minus 3 will be coming here. So you have to draw a line by cutting y is equal to minus 3. So this is the graph of y is equal to 4. And the graph of the constant function will be always like this, which will be parallel to the x-axis and passing through a particular point in the y-axis. Now we have to go for finding out the domain and range. As we know that our input values, all x values, are from R, so the domain is R. Then the range means all values of y. All values of y means whatever input you give from the real number system, you will be getting a particular constant, that is called a c. That means all values of y will be a constant. That is equal to range is c. Since we have assumed here y is equal to c, our constant we have assumed as c, so range is equal to c. So range, when we write, we can write it as set of c. Next we shall discuss the third type, that is a polynomial function. A function f from R to R is defined in such a way that f of x is equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus etc plus an x power n. So this is a general form of a polynomial function. And here, n is a non-negative integer. N is a non-negative integer, means from 0 to any number, positive numbers will be coming. And a0, a1, a2, etc., an element of R. A0 means this one, a0, a1 coefficient of x, a2 coefficient of x squared. These are belongs to R, means real number system. So about this one, you might have learned in class 9 and 10 polynomials chapter. And let's take an example. The example will give you more clarity about the concept. Example, f of x is equal to, we can take a polynomial x cube minus 3x square plus 4x plus 2. This is a polynomial. Then here, f of x is equal to x power 19 minus 81. So this is also a polynomial function. Means if you give a particular input, we will be getting, means x, if you give a particular value, you will be getting f of x value or y value. Then these are the examples of polynomial function. And different polynomial functions will have different graphs. See, for example, if you are taking f from R to R, defined by f of x is equal to x cube. F of x equal to x cube means this is in this format, f of x equal to a0 plus a1x plus etc plus an x power n. So this is a polynomial function, and the graph of this one will be coming like this. Means just simply put the input value. See, for example, if you are putting x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0 means f of x is y. If you want, I will just write and show you. That is, x values and y values will be there. So y is equal to x cube, that is our function. Y is equal to x cube is our function. Then x, if you put 1, y will be 1. If I put x is equal to 0, y will be 0 cube. 0 cube is 0. If I put x is equal to 2, y will be 2 cube, that is 8. So you can see here the points which we have plotted. You can see here 1 will be coming here, 1 1, then 0 0 is here. Then if you take 2, almost it will be coming 8 here. Like that, if you plot the negative values, it will be going like this. So this is the graph of this polynomial function, f of x equal to x cube. And if you draw different, this is, for example, if you draw x power 19 minus 81, you will be getting another graph. So polynomial function, hope it is clear. Next we will be discussing about rational functions. Here, rational functions are functions of the type f of x by g of x. There is a numerator one function and a denominator another function. So f of x by g of x. And here, f of x and g of x are polynomial functions. We have discussed about polynomial functions in the previous slide. And provided there is a condition g of x, denominator should not be equal to 0. So rational function means numerator there will be one function and denominator there will be another function, f of x by g of x. When we take an example, it will be quite clear for you. F from R minus 0 to R, this is a function is defined. R minus 0 means real numbers excluding 0. 0 should be removed from the real numbers. To R, defined by f of x is equal to 1 divided by x. F of x equal to 1 divided by x. This is an example of rational functions. So when you draw the graph of f of x is equal to 1 by x, we will be getting a graph like this. Means if you want to check, we can check with some different points. There will be x value and there will be y value as well. And y value is this one, f of x is actually y. Y is equal to 1 by x. Then x, if you take 1, 0 we cannot take, because 0 if you take, y will be 1 by 0 format, it will be coming indeterminate form. So we can take from 1 positive values. 1 if you take, 1 divided by 1, 1 divided by 1 is 1. If you take 2, x is equal to 2, if you take 1 divided by 2, that is 0.5 will be coming. And some negative values, if you take, if x is equal to minus 1, if you take, it is 1 divided by minus 1, that is minus 1. If you take x is equal to minus 2, then minus 1 divided by minus 2, that is minus 0.5 will be coming. So some set of negative values, some set of positive values I have taken. 0 will not be coming, because if you put 0 here, 1 divided by 0, that is indeterminate form. So that's why this portion is excluded. The two separate graph will be coming like this. This is for the graph of 1 by x. And 1, 1, you can see, check here, 1 will be coming here between 0 and 2. 1 and 1 by 1 is 1. So almost here will be coming the point. Then next is, if you take 2, 0.5, 2, if you take just below 2, 1, it is 0.5 may be coming here. Then next is minus 1, if you take, it will be coming this side. Minus 1 will be somewhat here, and minus 1, then 1 will be coming here. Minus 1, minus 1 will be coming here. Then minus 2, if you take minus 2, this is minus 2, minus 2, then minus 0.5. just below minus 2 it is. So minus 0.5 will be coming, approximately coming here, okay? So this is the way we have to plot and check the graph. So the graph of y is equal to f of x equal to 1 by x, or y is equal to 1 by x, will be like this. Next, we shall discuss the modulus function. f from R to R. A function is defined from R to R. F of x is equal to modulus of x for each x element of R. F of x is equal to modulus of x for each x element of R. And here this is known as the modulus of x. The way of writing, that means in between two lines x, if it is written, then we can say that it is modulus of x. Here modulus of x is always positive, means even if you substitute a negative value inside, for example minus 3, if you put a minus 3 inside, we will be getting the answer of this as 3. Means modulus means positive without sign. If you put something with the sign inside, it will be coming out without sign. Negative means positive will be coming. So modulus of x is always positive. Let's define it in a little more detailed way. That is, f of x is equal to minus x if x less than 0. Less than 0 means 0, below 0 means negative values will be x will be minus x, and plus x if x is greater than 0. 0 or above positive values means it will be plus x. So f of x is equal to minus x if x less than 0, f of x is equal to x if x greater than or equal to 0. 0 or above 0 means it will be x. Let's see how the graph it will be looks like. So x less than 0, some values I am taking. X less than 0 means negative values, minus 1, minus 2. So x minus 1 means surely when it comes inside the modulus, it will be minus, but when it comes out, it will be plus. Okay, minus, modulus of minus 1 means plus 1, it is written. Modulus of minus 2 also same thing, positive value will be coming plus 2. Then some values greater than or equal to 0 means 0 and above 0, if you check 0, 1, 2. Modulus of 0 is 0, modulus of 1 means 1, modulus of 2 is 2. Here there is no sign, so same number will be coming out. So let's check the graph. All the necessary requirements we have completed here in the graph sheet. And first of all, minus 1, 1. So minus 1, 1 is here. The next is minus 2, 2. Minus 2, 2 will be here, minus 2, 2. The next, by connecting this one, we can draw a graph. And next set, if you take x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, it will be here, 0, 0, that we have marked. 1, 1 means 1, 1 will be coming here, that we have joined. Next is 2, 2. 2, 2 will be this way, okay? Then 2 and 2 we have marked. Then by connecting these three lines also, we can draw a line. So this is the graph of a modulus function. Next, let's define the domain and range. Domain, all the input values. If you check the input values, x less than 0, x greater than or equal to 0, all real number system is there. So all values of x that is equal to real numbers are. Then range means all values of y. When you check all values of y, there are no negative values. All the outputs will be positive. You can see here 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, all positive values. Because when we put inside the modulus a negative number, the positive numbers will be coming out. So all positive real numbers and 0. So all positive real numbers and 0 are the range of the modulus function. Next, we shall discuss about the signum function. F from R to R. A function from R to R is defined. F of x is equal to set of all 1 if x greater than 0, 0 if x is equal to 0, minus 1 if x less than 0. F of x will take the value 1, means y will be 1 when x is greater than 0. X greater than 0 means all positive values of x, means x is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. All positive values of x, y will be equal to 1. If x is equal to 0, means f is equal to 0, means y will take the value 0. If x is less than 0, x is less than 0 means f of x will take the value minus 1. Less than 0 means negative numbers is, if it is given for x, y will be minus 1. For example, if you are taking as 10, 10 is greater than 0, means y will be equal to 1. If x is 100, that is greater than 0, y will be taking as 1. If x is 0 means surely y also will be 0 as per condition. Then if x is less than 0 means negative numbers, any negative number. For example, x is equal to minus 2, y will be minus 1. If x is minus 100, y will be minus 1. If x is minus 1000, y will be minus 1. So this is the way this signum function is defined. let's take some set of points. X less than 0 means from here, x less than 0 means negative numbers, minus 1, minus 2, 2 numbers I'm taking. When x is minus 1, y will be, as per the definition, it is minus 1. When x is minus 2, again it is less than 0, that's why y will be also minus 1. Then when x is equal to 0, as per the condition, y also will be equal to 0. Then when x is positive, means greater than 0, I'm taking two positive numbers, 192. When x is 1, y also will be 1. When x is 2, since it is positive, x greater than 0, that's why y value will be 1. So this is the way we just allot the points for plotting the graph. In the graph sheet, if you plot minus 1, minus 1, that is the first element, first point we have plotted. Then minus 2, minus 1, that is here, minus 2, minus 1 that we have plotted. Then by joining these two points, you can draw a line. You can see here, there is an empty dot, just a white color empty dot I just mentioned here. It means that minus 1 is not included. In this line, minus 1 is not included. Just before minus 1, you have to stop. Means, if minus 1 is taken, means the coordinate will be x is 0, y is minus 1. If you take the ordered pair here, it will be 0 minus 1. X value 0, y value will be minus 1. But x value 0 means y value must be 0 as per our condition. So that's why you have to stop just before minus 1. That's why this empty dot we have mentioned. Next is 0, 0. Next point we have plotted. Next, 1, 1 that we have plotted here. Next is 2, 1. And by connecting these two points also, we can just draw a line. Here also, there is an empty dot, means 1 is not included. If 1 is included, means what will happen? If you take the ordered pair, x value will be 0, y value will be 1. X value will be 0, y value will be 1. When x is 0, as per our definition, y must be 0, not 1. So that's why you have to stop just before reaching 1, means 1 is not included. So this is the graph of the signum function. Then domain and range we have to write. Domain means it is quite clear, any input value we can take from the real numbers. So domain is R, but our range is restricted. Range is having only three values, 1, 0 and minus 1. Whatever x value you put, y value will be these three. So range will be set of all 0, 1, minus 1. Next, we shall discuss about the last function, that is greatest integer function. Here, the function f from R to R is defined. F of x is equal to greatest integer x. This one we can read it as greatest integer x. X should be within the square brackets. Then we read as greatest integer x. So here, this representation is the greatest integer less than or equal to x. Whatever value is there inside x, when we take the value outside of this greatest integer bracket, then we will be taking the integer which is less than or equal to x. Which is less than or equal to x means, let's take some example and that time it will be more clear to you. For example, greatest integer 0.0001. So here it's a very small number. So when it comes out of the bracket, the greatest integer which is less than or equal to x, here 0.0001 means an integer which is less than this number is clearly zero. Integers means we know that it includes negative numbers, zero and positive integers. Positive numbers, these are called integers. Negative numbers, zero and positive integers. If you want, I will just write and show you. From etc it will start, from etc it start, then it will be start writing minus 2 we can write, then minus 1, next will be 0, next will be coming as 1, next is 2 and so on, it goes up to infinity. These are called integers. And greatest integer means when we write outside the bracket, we will be writing the integer which is less than or equal to the given number, which is less than or equal to the given number. Here 0.0001 means it is very close to 0, a number integer which is less than this number is 0 itself. Then next number 0.1. 0.1, if you want to represent it in a number line, you can see here, if you take this one as a number line, this will be 0 and this will be 1 we can take. And here 0.1 means somewhat very close to 0, maybe here it will be coming. So very close, to 0 means a an integer which is less than or equal to x, smaller than this value. Smaller than this value is clearly it is 0. So that's what it is mentioned here. Next is 0.9999. Here when you check 0.99 means it is very close to 1. So the integer which is less than or equal to x, that means it will be less than means you have to move to the left side, no need to go to the right side. When you go to right side, it becomes, even though it is very close to 1, if you move or if you select the right side number, it will be greater. But here it is asked less than. Less than means anyway you have to come to 0 only. So that will be equal to 0. Next is greatest integer 1. Greatest integer 1 means 1 itself, because 1 itself is an integer. Next is greatest integer 0. So 0 is also an integer, so greatest integer is 0 itself. Next is 1.01. 1.01 means it is quite clear the number and or an integer which is less than 1.01 is 1 itself. So 1 we will be writing. Next is 1.9999. Even though this one is very close to 2, but an integer which is less than 1.999 is 1. So we will be writing the answer as 1. Next is 2.2. So the integer which is less than 2.2 is 2 itself, that it is written. Then minus 0.1 means just we will be explaining along with the number line. So minus 1 will be maybe the left of 0 it is. I am using the previous line itself. So here minus 0.1 means here it will be coming, maybe somewhere here. So minus 0.1, an integer which is less than minus 0.1 means from the number line, less than numbers if you take, you have to take to the left side, that means the number is -1. So that is what it is written here. The greatest integer which is less than minus 0.1 is -1 itself. Then minus 0.5 also it will be here in between 0 and -1. The number or an integer which is less than -0.5 is -1, that is written here. So -1.1, if you take -1.1 means it is just behind -1. Here will be coming means just behind this number there will be -2. So -2 will be here. Then if you take -1.1 means maybe somewhere here -1.1. So to take the smallest number or which is less than the given number means you have to go to left side, because it is a negative number, that means we will be reaching to -2. That's what it is mentioned here, -2. So when you represent this one in graphical format, it looks like this. See, for example, here there are different lines, small lines we have drawn, and at one end it is an empty circle is mentioned. This empty circle we have already discussed in the previous slide, means that particular number is not included. So here when you take x2, here 2 is not included, just behind 2 it will stop. And here when you check, 3 is not included, and here when you check, 4 is not included, and here if you take -1 x value, that is -1 is not included. Then here when you check, here also -1 is not included, here 0 is not included, here -2 is not included. So suppose, for example, if you want to take this 1.01, how do we calculate from here? 1.01 means x value 1.01, input value 1.01 comes just after 1. Just after 1 means when you move up, it will be here. It is a concrete line, means this will be the point, y value. That means it is 1. So it is mentioned here. 1.999 means it will be coming here. X value 1.99 means just close to 2. Just close to 2, when you go to y axis, it will be again, it is reaching up to 1 only, y axis. So that's what it is mentioned. And here when you check greatest integer 1, how do we check? So x value is 1. So x value 1 here. So just you have to move up means here we will reach. So the greatest integer of 1 is 1 itself, that is what it is mentioned. So hope it is clear. Next we shall discuss algebra of functions. Here mainly we will be discussing addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of functions. Also we will be discussing multiplication of a function by a scalar. F from x to r, a function is defined f from x to r. Here x is a subset of r. Here x is a subset of r means a real number system. R is a real number system. And r is real are real functions. Here, as we have discussed before, r is a real number system and both are real functions, real valued functions. What does it mean, real valued function? Let's check the definition. A function which has either r or one of its subsets as its range is called a real valued function. Further, its domain is also either r or a subset of r. It is called a real valued function. Means a function whose domain and range is either r or a subset of r. R means real numbers. Its domain and range both are r real numbers. R means real numbers or subset of r. Here subset of r is x. Then we can say that it is real valued functions. Once again, you have to check the domain and range. This domain and range must be r means real numbers or a subset of real numbers. Then we can say that that particular function is a real valued function. Here f from x to r is a real valued function. Then addition, how do we add two functions? F plus g of x is equal to just individually add the functions, that is f of x plus g of x. Let's take an example. F of x is equal to x and g of x is equal to x minus 1. Then when we discuss, or when we are just doing f plus g of x, means we have to add the individual functions, means f of x plus g of x. What is f of x? F of x is x. What is g of x? It is x minus 1. Just to add it, x plus x minus 1. X plus x, when we add, we will be getting 2x minus 1 is the answer. Next is subtraction. Same like addition, only subtraction also. F minus g of x is equal to f of x minus g of x. Individually we have to subtract. Let's take an example. Same functions only, f of x is equal to x and g of x is equal to x minus 1. Then f minus g of x, subtraction means individually we have to subtract. That will be x minus, f of x will be x minus g of x. What is g of x? G of x is x minus 1. Here you have to put a bracket, minus of x minus 1, because after minus there are two terms, that's why. When you remove the bracket, x, minus into minus, plus 1. So minus x plus x will be cancelled and you will be getting the answer as 1. Then multiplication by scalar. Multiplication by scalar means alpha f of x. Alpha is a scalar quantity here. Then what we have to do is just to take alpha outside, just to multiply with the function alpha into f of x. Then alpha is a scalar quantity here. Let's take an example. 2f of x means just to take this 2 scalar quantity outside, then multiply separately with the f of x. 2f of x, 2 into f of x means 2 into our f of x is x, so that is 2 into x. Next is multiplication. Multiplication, fg of x is equal to, individually you have to multiply the functions, f of x into g of x. Let's take an example. As before, we have taken f of x is equal to x, g of x equal to x minus 1. Then fg of x is equal to, individually multiply the functions, f of x into g of x. F of x into g of x means x into x minus 1. When you multiply it, it comes as x square minus x. Next is division. Division of functions. F by g of x is equal to f of x by g of x. Individually, we have to divide, provided g of x should not be equal to 0. Because denominator, we cannot keep 0, because division by 0 is not defined. Then example, when you take f of x is equal to x and g of x is equal to x minus 1. Then f by g of x is equal to, as per the definition, f of x by g of x. Then what is f of x? F of x is x divided by x minus 1. So this is the division of algebraic functions. Hope it is clear. Dear students, today we have discussed the basic concepts of functions, types of functions, its domain and range, and algebra of functions. I request all the students to go through these definitions as well as the graphs, especially the types of functions, its domain and range. While practicing, if you have any doubt, please note it and keep. We will discuss it during the discussion session. Thank you for watching.